Hello everyone, this discussion is for class 4 students and the subject is mathematics. The topic will be discussed is from your chapter 2. So open your book, open chapter number 2. There you can find Roman numerals. So today we will discuss about Roman numerals. In the previous class, you studied the Roman numerals. Just let us revise them. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 as 10 numerals to represent the numbers in Hindu-Arabic number system. Likewise, we have 7 symbols in Roman number system. These symbols are given below with their corresponding Hindu-Arabic numerals. So the Hindu-Arabic numeral 1 is represented by I in Roman numeral. The Hindu-Arabic numeral 5 is represented with V in Roman numeral. Similarly, 10 is represented by X, 50 is represented by L, 100 is represented by C, 500 is represented by capital D, and 1000 is represented by capital M in Roman number system. There is no symbol for 0 in Roman number system. So there are some basic rules for writing the Roman numerals or Roman numbers. There are 4 basic rules to write the Roman numbers. So the first number is the rule for the single digit numbers. So the first rule is for the single digit numbers. Only the symbols I, X, C and M can be repeated up to 3 times. Repetition of symbols means addition. For example, I means 1 plus 1 equals to 2. Similarly, 3 can be written as triple I in Roman number system. 30 will be written as triple X. CCC, that is triple C, it can be written as 100 plus 100 plus 100. That means 300. And double M or MM equals to 1000 plus 1000, that is equals to 2000. This is because the repetition of symbols indicates the addition. As see in this number MM, M is repeated 2 times, that means there will be addition. And M indicates 1000. This is why 1000 plus 1000, which gives us a result of 2000. Rule number 2. A smaller numeral written to the right of a larger numeral is always added to the larger numeral. For example, see in this example, it is written 5 plus 1 equals to 6. The 6 can be written in Roman numeral as VI. So as V indicates 5 and I indicates 1, and here 1 that is written to the right of 5, that is the larger number, and 1 is the smaller number. See here, I is smaller and V is larger in Roman numeral. So as in this number, I, that is the smaller number, is written right to the larger number, that is V here. So what will we do? We will add the smaller number, that is I, that indicates 1, to the larger number, that is V, that indicates 5. This is why 1 plus 5 or 5 plus 1 gives us a result of 6. Similarly, VIII, that indicates that there is the smaller number written at the right side of the larger number V. V is larger number because V indicates 5 and I is smaller number because I indicates 1. As 1 is written right side of the larger number 5, so this is why we can tell that it will be an addition. And this is how, as V indicates 5 and I indicates 1, so the solution will be 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals to 8. Similarly, other examples are also there, like 11, 60, 15, 8, 2. We'll have to practice. We all will have to practice how to write all these numbers. Now, rule number 3. A smaller numeral written to the left of a larger numeral is always subtracted from the larger numeral. So in rule 2, we have seen when smaller numeral is written to the right side of the larger numeral, that smaller numeral is added to the larger numeral. And rule 3 is exactly opposite of rule 2, where the smaller numeral is written at the left side of the larger numeral. And if the smaller numeral is written at the left side of the larger numeral, then that smaller numeral will always be subtracted from the larger numeral. For example, in Roman numeral, it is written IV. We all know now that I indicates 1 and V indicates 5. So here I is the smaller numeral and V is the larger numeral. As I is the smaller numeral and it is written at the left side of the larger numeral, that is V, so I will be subtracted from V in digital numbers. So I indicates 1. Here 1 will be subtracted from 5. So it will be 5 minus 1, that is equals to 4. In the same way, we can write the number 49, 90, etc. We will have to practice this. Some points to be remembered are V, L and D are never subtracted. I can be subtracted from V and X. X can be subtracted from L and C. Now rule 4. When a smaller numeral is placed between two larger numerals, then it is always subtracted from the larger numeral placed immediately after it. So now we have learned what will happen if the smaller numeral is placed at the right side of the larger numeral. At the same time, we have also learned what will happen if the smaller numeral is placed at the left side of the larger numeral. Now, what will happen if the smaller numeral is placed between two larger numerals? So, rule 4 is telling us the solution. Here, as I said, the smaller numeral will always be subtracted from the larger numeral placed immediately after it or next to it. For example, we can see the number 14. It is written in Roman numeral as XIV, where X indicates 10, I indicates 1, and V indicates the digital number 5. As I is 1 or I indicates 1, and it is placed between two larger numbers, that is X and V, or 1 is written just between two larger numbers, 10 and 5. So what will happen? 1 will be subtracted from the number immediately that comes immediately after it or next to it. So here we can see 1, after 1, 5 is written here. That means 1 will be subtracted from 5, because 5 comes immediately after 1 or just next to 1, there is 5. So as 1 is the smaller number in XIV or 14, I is the smaller number, I indicates 1. So 1 will be subtracted from the number that comes immediately after it. So 5 comes immediately after it. So 1 will be subtracted from it. And as I said before, that when the numbers are written one after another, it means addition. So XIV will indicate, where X indicate 10, plus 1 will be subtracted from the next number, that is 10 plus 5 minus 1 equals to 14. Next, first we will see rule number 5. In rule number 5, it is said, while writing a Roman numeral, we make sure that the tens is placed on the left and ones on the right. So we first write Roman numerals for tens and then for ones. For example, 68 equals to 60 plus 8. That means in Roman numerals, it will be LXVIII. So in this number 68, we will write the tens number first. We will write it in a way that we are making addition. So 60 plus 8. So the tens, we will write the number of tens first. That means 60. We will write 60 as LX. And then comes number 8, that is written in Roman numeral as VIII. So while writing a Roman numeral, we will make sure that the tens is placed on the left and the ones on the right. So we first write the Roman numeral for tens and then for ones. I hope you have understood properly how the Roman numerals are written. And here you can see a table is there which is showing the Roman numerals with their Hindu Arabic numerals up to 100. You'll have to practice it. And now for a quick review, let's see a short video.